Measuring temperature is a common lab activity for students, and Vernier has several different ways of being able to do this. One of our most popular probes is our stainless steel temperature probe, and it covers most temperatures that you probably would use in the classroom. You want to do melting of ice or boiling of water or whatnot, even put this in different acids, you can do that. So it's one of the reasons that it's used very commonly in the labs. But we have some other choices. Next is the wide range temperature probe, and the key feature for this one is the fact that it can go to a higher temperature than our stainless steel temperature probe. So the idea is that you might be using this in an organic lab and you need to go up to temperatures as high as 330 degrees Celsius. This one can do this. It's also obviously physically larger and it's designed to have the same size shaft as a standard alcohol thermometer. Next would be the surface temperature sensor. And this one has a very fine wire that is very responsive to temperature. So its response time is much faster than some of the other sensors and probes. You could tape it to your skin. And so it just gives you some options of other ways of measuring temperature. Next is the go-temp. And this is a temperature sensor that plugs into the computer via the USB port. So the other ones that we've seen actually would go into one of our data loggers like a LabQuest 2 or a LabQuest Mini or something like that. This you actually plug into the computer, the USB port. And it's very similar to our stainless steel in terms of its ranges, but it just gives you that ability to do that. And it's an inexpensive way to get started if you already have a computer. Next would be the ez-tmp. And this is a temperature sensor that plugs into the TI devices, a TI Inspire, a TI-84 calculator. So it has a mini USB port that's there. Now it turns out that the ez-tmp and the go-temp are actually very similar electronically. The main difference is the size of the USB ports. And we do sell adapters that allows you to make the go-temp into an ez-tmp or vice versa. So it's really just the difference in the size of that. But so depending on what device you have, if you have a TI device, you probably would go with the ez-tmp for that. Next would be the infrared thermometer. This allows me to measure temperatures of an object without having to touch it. All of these other sensors and probes have to be in contact with what it is you're going to measure the temperature. This one actually measures the temperature via the infrared radiation coming from the object. And so the radiation comes in here and you get the temperature reading. And then lastly would be the extra long temperature probe. And so it's has the sensor here. And the main difference with this one is the length of the cord. This one is used sometimes to measure, say, the temperature profile of a pond, or you want to measure the temperature on the roof of the school without having to go up there. So you could put this up there and be able to monitor it that way. So there are a lot of different options for being able to measure temperature. So you could check our catalog or our website and see which one is correct for you.